Hey everyone, it's time for another LACO Fact Check. Now you've heard me say it a thousand times, we need to send the water south to protect our estuaries and our safety and the integrity of the Herbert Hoover Dyke. We must restore the natural flow of water in Lake Okeechobee and send more water south into Florida's Everglades. Over the past 25 years, Congress has authorized nearly $6 billion with a B dollars on infrastructure projects to do just that. That's why I worked with Congresswoman Mercuso Paul on the bipartisan legislation to say, quote, let's use the infrastructure and send more water south during the dry season. But at the last minute, the language was stripped out of legislation when lobbyists from the sugar industry swooped in and they opposed it. This was appalling enough. But then, last month at a hearing held by the Transportation and Infrastructure Committee, a representative of the sugar industry said, and I quote, that he obviously supports the goal of moving more water south. Now this is an easy fact check. If that was the case, then why did they literally oppose the language in the bill in July to prevent more water from flowing south? Why did the U.S. Sugar Corporation sue the Army Corps of Engineers to say they can't hold the water in Lake Okeechobee even one drop lower? And why in the same hearing did the sugar industry say they were happy with the water management status quo that doesn't move enough water south? You can't have it both ways. You can't claim you want to send more water south and then say that the current practice of hoarding water on Lake Okeechobee is your preferred management strategy. Actions speak far louder than the words on this one. And that's a LACO Fact Check.